In Unit 2 of this course, you'll learn the basic elements of creating a simple web page using XHTML. This unit is all about the actual content of your web pages, the text that people will be able to read. The form of the pages, the aesthetics, is intentionally split off into the next unit. You can worry about making it pretty then. For now, let us focus on what you actually want to say. Prior to doing any actual coding, you'll continue the good foundation you laid in Unit 1 by sketching out the site on paper. With the site's purpose and target audience in mind, we can plan out the site. While the structure of the image portfolio site you'll create in this course is essentially planned out for you, you'll do a pre-planning exercise to at least get you thinking about these elements. Next, you'll familiarize yourself with the basic tenets of XHTML, a special, somewhat stricter version of HTML that you'll be using to code your pages. You'll learn about common XHTML tags, their syntax, their uses, and how to effectively order them in your page. No special software is necessary. All you need to start creating web pages right now is a simple text editor, a web browser, and a bit of coding know-how. The first two are part of your operating system, and you'll acquire the third in this unit. You will soon discover the difference between essential tags, those tags required to designate a text document as an actual web page, and common tags, which are the building blocks of your content. Components like headlines, paragraphs, and dividing lines are all examples of common tags. Next, you will move on to creating lists, both ordered and unordered. You'll even learn how to nest one list inside another to set up a hierarchy of list items. Of course, the main advantage to putting content on the web is its inherent ability to link to other sources of interest. In this unit, you'll learn how to add links both to external sites as well as other pages in your own site. You'll even discover special kinds of links such as bookmarks, linking to a specific part of a page, and email links that will open the user's email client to send you a message. In our final lesson in this unit, you'll find out how to add tables of information to your site. Tabular information is great for showing numerical data, schedules, or any other cross-section of information.